Evening, boys and girls. Mike here, one go short play, and tonight we are playing The Adventures of Bayou Billy for the NES. Looks good. It's still my birthday eve, and I am determined to play a game on the NES that I would consider good. So far, we've played a few, and they've all been a bit. This might be better. I'm not reading what it's saying there, but that looks promising. Nice dithering, nice graphics. Liking the look of that. Two game modes. Let's start with game A. I've seen carts of this, I think. I don't know if I saw them for real or if they were just... Ooh. Or if it was online or something. Nice in their share. And this time he's grounded with a drop shadow. Oh, yeah. This is what I'm talking about. It's a brawler. Okay, let's find your buttons. I'm not sure if there's any rhyme or reason to the... avoiding taking hits. Maybe there is. I think you've got to hit and move. Hit and move. Hit and move, Bayou Billy. Bayou Billy. Bayou, Bayou Billy. Bayou, Bayou Billy. Billy Bob. Bayou. Yeah, this is cool. I'm liking it. Okay, your controls are pretty simplistic. You can punch or kick. They're pretty much the same move, just with a different image on top. Which is okay. Those baddies aren't very intelligent. But that, I have no problem with that. It means more chance of winning the fight for me. Actually, I've just realised that my screen grab is not quite picking up the whole screen. There's a few pixels at the bottom. Die. Actually, that's as far down as I can walk, so it's alright. But yeah, there's a bit more art at the bottom of the screen there. It's not picking up. Some games seem to be taller than others. How did he do that? I want to do that. He did a junkie. Maybe you press both buttons together. There's only two buttons. Yeah, it is. Oh, right. I think we just figured out how to win. How to win at Nintendo. Yeah, you can try your flying kick. Your cheap flying kick tricks. But I'm going to be cheaper. Oh yeah, I'm button bashing that flying kick. This is what we call spam. Oh, that was sneaky. Oh, I'm having that. Actually, that was really not the time I needed that, was it? When I needed that was about 30 seconds ago, when I was just about to lose that last life. I'm not sure what the AI is playing at. I mean, what's he doing? What's Gary Glitter doing? Despite the fact that all the baddies are basically the same dude in a different palette. And by palette, I mean a different single colour. No, you don't. And despite the fact that we are getting some seriously cheap enemy encounters now. Really. Oh, this is cheap. I quite like this. It's good. It's got, what was that game? Was it called Roar or something? The arcade coin off with the dude with the hat, and it's all about like rescuing animals from fair trade or something. I might be getting that wrong, making that up as I go along. It was cool, and it was like an arcade game, very Capcom style arcade game. I don't think it was a Capcom game though, but it was beautiful and it was full of cool weapons and really nice boss encounters and stuff. I'd like you pick up like submachine guns and stuff as far as I can remember and really kick ass in it. This looks a bit like that. It doesn't play anything like that, of course. But it looks a bit like it. And that's commendable. Well, that was easy. I couldn't pick up the big rock, but I just walked over this thing. Have I just found a glitch? Ah, we can get around that. I am just smacking people over the face with a stick. What's not to like? What is not to like? Have that glitter. Ooh, he's packing. There's a lot of flicker going on. Yeah, whatever, let's get off this fight. Fight him, fight him! Oh, back a bit. That's alright. That's forgivable. I will not allow you to throw that there. Serious flicker going on. I mean, we lose whole sections of sprites. And it's not even a flicker sometimes. It's just losers. Dudes lose their feet. Dudes lose their faces. I mean, I know. It's just a limitation of the device. You've got to live with that. I'm guessing this isn't a two-player game. I mean, if anyone's played Double Dragon on the Master System, great game. Totally not the arcade Double Dragon. But there's a heck of a lot of flicker on it. As far as I remember. You know what? I might have got totally wrong. It was years ago I played that. But that flicker you can see, those whole squares of characters disappearing. It's not really a flicker, it just disappears. You're not seeing like a dodgy frame rate version like you sometimes get on YouTube. That is literally what happens. It just disappears. The feet disappear. That said, woo, that was close. That was just luck. Don't know how I avoided that. That said, I'm quite liking this. Although I keep dying in the same place, and that is frustrating. Yeah. Stage one. This stage, use the controller as opposed to what? Oh, no, not the beginning. Oh, that's silly. Now, I think the unforgivable sin, or the unforgivable mistake they've made here, which would stop me from going out and buying this cart, is, because as you know, because I don't really mention it that much, I'm looking for NES games that I might want to buy for my actual NES, that I bought a while ago. This one I would go for, but there's a serious flaw, which is good brawlers tend not to start you again on the level. They don't share that with old school platformers. I suppose in, like in Shinobi, when you die, you go back to the beginning of the level. A good brawler doesn't really do that. Streets of Rage, Double Dragon, Final Fight. What happens when you lose a life? What happens when you lose a credit? Is it all happens live? So the countdown happens around the gameplay. You lose a life, you get up again. That's really harsh. If you haven't got a weapon, it's really harsh. And that's going to put me back now. I've got to do that again. That doesn't happen in a good brawler. Which means this is not a good brawler, which is a shame. Because I want it to be a good brawler. Because it looks like a good brawler. This game looks great for a NES game. I just want it to be as good as it looks. And to be honest, this fight is a bit Renegade 3, you know? Just standing there tapping the button. Well, even Renegade 3 had a bit of tactics to it, even if it was rubbish tactics for a rubbish game. But, I don't know. The way to play this game seems to be dance around doing jump kicks so you don't get hit, or you get hit as little as possible. Because if you stop and punch or kick, you just get hit and killed, and that's that. I love that chicken though, I'll tell you that for nothing. As long as you're moving left or right when you do a jump kick, you tend to be okay. But, it's not fun. This is just frustrating. Oh, I've had enough. It looks lovely. Wish it was better than it was. A few simple little things would have fixed it. Maybe a bit more gameplay. Can I kick an eagle out of the air? That would really improve this game. Even though I abhor cruelty to animals. But let's face it. It's self-defense, officer. The animal attacked me first. Yeah, we're getting a bit of a variety in the baddies. That's kind of cool. I mean, I should have picked up on that before. But I was too busy smacking them in the face with a stick. I've got a feeling we're limited for what baddie types we can have because they're all the same dude. I just wish it was better. I do. Still, there it is. The Adventures of Bayou Billy for the NES. Thanks for watching.